Hey guys, welcome to another episode of How Not to Do Car Audio, and I'm working on a Ford Mustang, and I'm going to do the harness, but I thought I would show this to you guys because I actually see this every once in a while still, and I don't know why. Now, if you look at the solder connections, they look good. That's not my problem. Even the butt connectors, they're not the kind I like, or even the way it's crimped, it would still work. My problem that I'm having is here is, you have both. Me and Trevor were talking about it, we're like, pick one. It's still the exact same color. You have white here and white there. It's not like you couldn't figure out what the color you needed to use was. So why not just cut it off here, start fresh? Why would you cut it over here and then put this stuff all over it? When you have two different types of connections on one harness, one, it looks like ass. Two, now you've doubled up the points of failure. So on a soldering connection, you'd only have one point of failure for it to break apart. Now we have another point of failure on one end of the butt connector and another point of failure on the other end of the butt connector. So now we have a grand total of three failure points, possible failure points on the connection per wire, when you can reduce it down to either two or one. I've now finished the harness. You can see I went and I chose to do the solder and shrink tube, and then I used Tesla tape to harness it all together. You could also do zap straps or zip ties all the way across, or you can use the thick harness tape from Tesla and cover the whole thing. It's up to you. But the main point of the video is, only do one connection per wire. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Facebook and Instagram, AnthonyJ350, and also check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca.